OGF, the online platform for GATE Agriculture Engineering. And this is all about me. And friends, today we are going to discuss the heat and mass transfer chapter, in which I will cover the heat transfer in heat transfer video for complete theory, and after that I will solve all the previous year questions asked on this topic. First of all, it starts with conduction process. Friends, conduction is the process in which heat is transferred from one portion of the body to another portion by the solid medium. Means, friends, conduction takes place when there is temperature difference between the two surfaces. You see here the formula for conduction. That is, Q of wall is equal to minus Ka T2 minus T1 divided by L is equal to minus T2 minus T1 by RT. Friends, you see here simple. You see here that a wall is there, and at the left surface of the wall the temperature is T1, and at the right surface of the wall the temperature is T2, and the total length is L, and the area is A, and the here see that the material conductivity is the K. We represent it as K. And friends, you should take care that here the minus sign is implemented before the formula. It clearly mentions that the heat is flowing in the direction opposite to the direction of temperature difference. Means, suppose initial temperature is T1 and final temperature is T2. Means, it is clearly that heat is flowing from T1 to T2. Means, from higher potential to lower potential. You remember it, friends, it is a universal law that heat always flow from, either it is heat or otherwise it is current, it will always flow from the higher potential to lower potential. Means, from higher values to lower values. Let us understand it by an example. Suppose that you are touching an ice ball. Suppose you are touching one ice cube by your fingers. When you touch, your body temperature is normal, human body temperature is 37 degree centigrade. And you all know that the temperature of ice cube is 0 degree centigrade. When you are touching it, then heat is transferred from your body to the ice cube, so that the ice cube starts melting. Friends, from here you should understand that heat always flow from higher potential to lower potential. And that's why, friends, here the sign is taken as negative sign. And friends, you should take care about the units. The cube is the amount of heat transfer per unit time. Means, its unit is power. Means, joule per time is watt. And K unit is means material conductivity unit is watt per meter per Kelvin. And L is simply in meter, and area is simply in meter square. Now see the convection. Friends, convection is simply the heat is transferred from the material to the fluid. Whatever the fluid, suppose it is, whether it is a liquid or otherwise gas or air, what is surrounding the material is the medium to transfer the heat from material to the fluid or fluid to the material. So convection always takes place when both the mediums are different. Means, one medium is the solid and another medium is the fluid. Means, either liquid or gas. And you see here clearly that the Q value means the amount of heat flow per unit time is equal to HA into TW minus T0. Friends, here you see that TW minus T0 means you can assume that the TW means material temperature is greater than the fluid temperature. But sometimes, friends, it is reversed, that the fluid temperature is greater than the material temperature. You see here the units and the each and every term is written here clearly that heat transfer coefficient is the H value, A is the area contacting the fluid. Friends, you clearly understand that area is the whatever area which is surrounding the which are in contact with the fluid, means not the total area. Suppose I have given one spherical ball and it's only one surface of the spherical ball is in contact with the fluid and another three surfaces are in contact with another thing, then you consider only one surface of the sphere, means you see here that area, here area is the area contacting the fluid, and T2, T1 are the temperature differences. Friends, you should clearly understand that जो कंडक्शन होता है वो मटेरियल के अंदर में, सॉलिड मटेरियल में हीट ट्रांसफर का प्रोसेस है. मीन्स कंडक्शन हमेशा हमारा जो होगा, सपोज हमने किसी चीज को टच किया या फिर हमने, मीन्स कोई भी सॉलिड बॉडी है उसके अंदर का हीट ट्रांसफर प्रोसेस है. जबकि कन्वेक्शन जो होता है वो हमेशा ही सॉलिड से फ्लूइड का हीट ट्रांसफर प्रोसेस होता है. आपको इन दोनों चीजों के बीच डिफरेंस को याद रखना है. कंडक्शन ऑलवेज सॉलिड टू सॉलिड, मीन्स विद इन द सॉलिड बॉडी इट हीट ट्रांसफर टेक्स प्लेस, बट इन कन्वेक्शन देयर इज ऑलवेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन द बोथ द मीडियम्स, मीन्स सॉलिड टू फ्लूइड, फ्लूइड टू सॉलिड, लाइक दैट टेक्स प्लेस, देन इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ कन्वेक्शन. एंड फ्रेंड्स, अनदर थिंग आई विल टोल्ड यू, here you see that heat transfer coefficient, that is H value, you see that the unit of heat transfer coefficient is watts per meter square per degree Celsius, but the unit for heat conductivity in conduction is, that is K value, is watt per meter per Kelvin, means per degree Celsius or degree Kelvin, no problem, you can take, but there you have seen that watt per meter square, and here you see that watt per meter. You see this minute, you remember this minute difference between both the units. And friends, you remember that here RT means normally whatever we have studied in our intermediate class about electricity and electrostatics chapter, that the resistance is, you all know that current is equal to potential difference by resistance. And here you see that it is similar to that, that is here amount of heat flow is equal to temperature difference by resistance. Friends, here this concept is similar to the concept whatever we have studied in our intermediate regarding currents. At currents we have potential difference hota hai mein, aur usko apan divide karte hai resistance se. Aur yahan pe kya ho raha hai ki heat, amount of heat past is equal to temperature difference divided by the resistance of the body. And friends, you have to only take care about the resistance. Whatever questions they have asked regarding this topic, they are twisting the questions based upon the calculation of resistance only. So I will give you many more concepts regarding resistance calculation, and you can get familiar with that. Here friends, you see that, here you see in the formula, that is T2 minus T1 divided by RT. When we are putting the values of RT, friends, from here we can conclude that the resistance RTH is equal to delta X divided by KA, means delta X is the length of the conductor material, means conduction material, and divided by K means hydraulic conductivity into area of the material. This is the case of conduction in plane wall. So friends, you have to remember each cases. There are so many cases are made in this topic. So you should see that it is the case of plane wall when the length of wall is given and the area is given and the temperature difference, temperature of both sides, means T1 and T2 are given, then you can calculate the amount of heat transferred and you can also calculate the resistance. But now you can see in the case of convection, friends, in case of convection, you can, if you are going to calculate what is the resistance value in case of convection, then you simply put T2 minus T1 divided by R. Here R you can get, that is 1 by HA, means the resistance value in case of convection is 1 by HA. Now friends, see that there are many concepts regarding this conduction and convection. When they both are taking place simultaneously, then we have to consider both the cases and we will calculate the resistance happening in conduction and convection, and after that we will calculate the whatever the heat transfer from that area. आपको इस टॉपिक में रेसिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट करना सीखना है. अगर आप वो सीख जाते हो तो रिमाइनिंग थिंग्स आप इजीली कर लोगे. सो यू शुड बी केयरफुल अबाउट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द नेट रेसिस्टेंस, मींस द ओवरऑल रेसिस्टेंस ऑफ द बॉडी. एंड फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इन वॉचिंग दिस इन वन टाइम, देन यू अगेन वॉच दिस, मींस you watch this until you can get clear with your concepts, and you are able, then after you are able to solve all the previous year questions or upcoming year question asked regarding this topic. So friends, you see here about this first. Here it is given that three materials are given, means material 1, material 2 and again material 1, means they both are coincident, means they both are touching each other. And friends, here the temperature is given, that the surface temperature T1 is given and T3 is given. Means from the left hand side, the material 1 is touching the atmosphere, means atmosphere, whatever the fluid is present, and that has temperature T1. And you see that from the rightmost point, the temperature is T3. Means जो सबसे लेफ्ट मटेरियल 1 का जो लेफ्ट पोर्शन है, जो कि हमारा फ्लूइड के कांटेक्ट में होगा, उसका टेम्परेचर दिया हुआ है T1, और जो मटेरियल 1 के अगेन सबसे राइट में है, मींस सबसे राइट वाला पोर्शन, तो उसका टेम्परेचर दिया है T3. तो फ्रेंड्स, हमें टोटल रेसिस्टेंस निकालने के लिए वी विल क्लियरली सी हियर दैट इट इज द केस ऑफ सीरीज कनेक्शंस. Means friends, you all, I think all of you know that there are two types of connections are there. One is series connection and another one is parallel connection of resistances. So friends, you can clearly understand from here that it is a case of series connection. Friends, series connection mein what is happening? In series connection, I think all of you know that the current passing is equal. Means in all the resistors, the equal current is passing. And here also you can see that the equal heat is passing, means the Q value you can see here that it is equal in all the bodies. Means in material 1, the amount of heat passing is equal to the amount of heat passing in material 2 and amount of heat passing in material 1. Means जो यहाँ पे heat pass होगा वो constant होता है series के case में. You have to remember this. Means सीरीज का जो केस होगा वो उसमें एंड टू एंड कनेक्शन होता है सीरीज के केस में. एंड सो यू ऑल नो दैट फॉर सीरीज फॉर्मूला, व्हेन वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द रेसिस्टेंस, दैट इज R1 प्लस R2 प्लस R3 प्लस डॉट Rn. मींस R नेट इज इक्वल टू R1 प्लस R2 प्लस, वी आर सिंपली एडिंग टेकिंग द सम ऑफ ऑल द रेसिस्टेंस प्रेजेंट इन द बॉडी. So the same thing we are doing here. The friends, here the first resistance, that is 1 by H1A. Means friends, here A is the, let us assume that A is the, all these three materials are symmetrical. So we can assume that A is the cross-sectional area of all these three materials. So no difference in the area of the of these materials. But friends, H1 is the convective heat transfer coefficient of fluid which is present at the leftmost side. Means H1 जो है वो convective heat transfer coefficient है fluid का, जो हमारे सबसे left material 1 है, जो उसके सबसे left में present है उसका. Means वहाँ पे जो resistance होगा I have previously told that here you can see that the resistance for convection is 1 by HA. So the same thing I have done here. Here I have calculated the resistance for the first material due to the convection is 1 by HA plus L1 by KA. Friends, here you see that L1 is the length of material 1. So you see in case of conduction, the resistance is delta X divided by KA. Means here in case of delta X, the length is given, that is L1. So L1 by KA. And after that, similarly L2 by K2A plus L1 by KA plus 1 by H2A. Means H2 is the rightmost side fluid hydraulic fluid thermal convective coefficient. Means H2 जो है वो हमारे सबसे राइट में जो मटेरियल प्रेजेंट है, मीन्स T3 टेम्परेचर के बगल में, वो उसका हाइड्रोलिक, उसका थर्मल कन्वेक्टिव हीट ट्रांसफर कोफिशिएंट है. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द केस ऑफ सीरीज इन इन कंडक्शन एंड कन्वेक्शन. व्हेन दिस बोथ टेक्स प्लेस साइमल्टेनियसली, दिस इज द केस ऑफ सीरीज व्हेन द रेसिस्टेंस एंड व्हेन द मटेरियल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन सीरीज. And after that you see here, when the materials are present in parallel, I think all of you know that the formula for parallel resistance is 1 by R net is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by ... Rn. Means, इसमें क्या होता है, इसमें कि हमारा, you see in case of series, the heat transfer is equal in all the materials. But in case of parallel, the heat transfer is not equal in all the materials. It is different. That means Q1, Q2, Q3. Suppose here it is three materials are given. Means red, green and yellow. In all these three materials, three different amount of heat is transferred. But friends, you remember that the total heat transfer means Q total is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Means sum of all these current is equal to the Q total. And you see that in case of parallel also everything is same. Means here you, when you are going to calculate, you can put that delta X1 by, for red color body, you can put that delta X1 by K1 A1. And for green color, delta H2 by K2 A2. And for yellow color, delta X3 by K3 X3. But when you are doing the sum here, you are doing the reciprocal. Means 1 by R net is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Friends, I will suggest all of you to please you do in your notebook and make the derive the formula, because it is very easy. I think all of you should derive. Here you see that in case of series, everything is simply added. Means simply resistance is added, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3. But here in case of parallel, it is not simply added. It is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So you should take care about that. Now friends, I will show you another case. Friends, in this case, I think it will clear all of your concepts. Here you see that there are three resistances are there, three materials are there, and one is red color, green color and yellow color. Friends, you see that the two materials, means the red color and the green color, are present in parallel. And when we are calculating the net amount of resistance due to this red color and green color is equivalent, is in series with the yellow color material. Means सबसे पहले ऐसे क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करने के लिए हमें जो रेड कलर और ग्रीन कलर का जो मटेरियल है उसकी रेसिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट करनी पड़ेगी, जो कि पैरेलल में है. मींस 1 by R net is equal to 1 by R resistance of green color material plus 1 by resistance of red color material. और इससे हमारी जो R net की वैल्यू आएगी, वॉट एवर वी गेट द R net वैल्यू, वी कैन एड दिस R net वैल्यू प्लस R of resistance of yellow color material. Means you see here I have made the circuit diagram. You see, easily understand from here. and after that you can calculate the overall resistance of the body. I think all of you should do in your notebook, then you can easily get the clear concept. I think this is not very tough. I think all of you have studied in your intermediate, so you can easily correlate with that.